Let's look at the Pwn Adventure 3 challenges. Overachiever is a pretty simple challenge because you just have to get all the achievements in game. So we don't really have to bother with it now, as we will get it eventually. But the Egg Hunter sounds cool. When we were reverse engineering and debugging the libgame logic library in previous episodes, we already stumbled over the golden eggs in the classes. So clearly there are golden eggs that we have to find for the Egg Hunter flag. And funnily enough, in one of the early episodes, when I tried to make a funny clip by flying out of the room where new characters spawn, I flew past something glowing that was really unexpected to see. So there I stumbled over the first golden egg that we can collect. But how can we find all the other eggs? Maybe we can find the other eggs by just exploring the map. Though that could take super long, and probably is not how it's supposed to be done. Now I'm wondering, how could I find the location of all eggs on the map? Our game client has to have this information in some way to render them in place. So I started by looking at the Golden Egg class. A golden egg is an item, which is an eye item, but all the functions don't really help us, they just return some information about the kind of item it is. Also, we don't even have a golden egg object anyway, so what are we actually looking for is something that gives us a reference to a golden egg, or even all eggs. Let's see if we can find anything that returns or handles golden eggs. When searching for it, we come across this function golden egg list in the game API class. We see that it returns a vector of item pickups, so why is it called golden egg list if it returns some item pickups? Well, that class, which is also an actor, can hold a reference to an eye item, and we know golden eggs are an item, and thus also an eye item, so this class here can have a reference to a golden egg. And on this item pickup class, we could also call item pickup or use, so that is definitely a good candidate. If we could get a reference to the game API, we could call the golden egg list function that returns a vector which we can use to go over each item and pick up or find the eggs. Maybe you remember this global game world variable that we found previously and was super useful. And during playing around with this, I also explored the other global variables. And the game variable here is actually a game API object. But when calling this in GDB, which I'm not sure if it works how I think it works, it seems to be empty. And there is another global variable called gEggs, which sounds like it could contain a list to all eggs, but also this one is empty. So I first thought, okay, this could mean the client doesn't directly have the information about the eggs, and maybe the server only sends us the position once we get close to it, as a way to prevent cheating or something. So I flew back to the spawn where I knew there was an egg, but the list was still empty. That is so weird. Though it also makes sense. If you set up your own server or watched the video, you might know that the libgamelogic library is not only used by the client, but also the server. Which is smart, because then whatever the client calculates is exactly what the server can calculate. No differences. So I guess the server will use the library here a little bit different and maybe has the list while the client doesn't. But the client still has to get the information about the egg somehow, because there's one right in front of us, so we have to know the position. The information must be somewhere in memory. That frustrated me a little bit. So I continued looking around and kinda had in the back of my head that an egg is also an actor via the item pickup class. And the game world object that we know also has a list of actors in the world. So maybe they are in that list. mActor is a set of actor references, so we can write a for loop to iterate over them. And now iActor is this actor reference, so we get the real actor reference with the M object. That's the same thing we did for the player in an earlier episode. Then you can even call getDisplayName on it, as well as getPosition to get the vector where this actor is located, so the XYZ coordinates. And I place that into our chat command system as a new command. So now in-game we can type actors and we get a list of all actors with their coordinates. Cool! And now let's just teleport to these locations and check out what we can find. Here's the first one. Okay, this just happened, try again. Ah, it's the chest of magma rock. So next one. This is the cow chest we already got. Ah, this is our first golden egg. New achievement, Chamber of Secrets, and a quest started, Egg Finder. Here we have another one, and another one. Oh, this is the blocky chest we already checked. We don't need to port to Major Pain because that's just an NPC. But this is another egg. Just out of curiosity, where was this cave? Let's fly up and get an overview. Interesting. And another one. Ooh, one in a fast travel place. Well, you see, there are quite a lot of eggs. Let's keep picking them up and fast forward. This is a weird spot. This location appears to be nothing special. But of course, it's special because an actor is supposed to be here. So I wonder what's going on here. Anyway. And the last location is this XKCD comic about Balmer Peak. XKCD comics are really cool, in case you don't know them, check them out. But damn, we still miss an egg. We have only 9 out of 10. But we visited our location. It's nowhere. Though, this one place here was weird. So is the last egg maybe here? I looked again at the disassembly in Binary Ninja and typed in egg in the function window and I found the Balmer Peak egg. Ah, so maybe their last egg is a special one. And the XKCD poster was called Balmer's Peak, as well as the place itself. So it must be here. But how do we get it? It's not just invisible, we can't press E to pick it up. But if you look at the Balmer Peak egg can use function, then you can see it seems to check for a Balmer Peak secret. And when we look at where else the secret is referenced, we can find it in the Balmer Peak poster damage method. What does the poster have to do with that? So I guess if we somehow reached this block here, we set the secret and could collect the egg. There is some kind of check or test before and it seems to have something to do with Cowboy Coder. And Cowboy Coder is a weapon we have. So I just assumed that if we now shoot at the poster, we damage the poster with the Cowboy Coder, we set the secret. Didn't seem to have done much, but let's check the spot. Oh yes, there it is now. The assumption was correct. Awesome. Acquired Flag of the Egg Hunter. The Fortress of Anorak is all yours. Cool, we solved another challenge. But I have more for you. Let me show you an example why I love making these videos, because I just told you how I solved it, right? But when I was retracing the steps it took me, I realized I never properly investigated these initialization methods when I thought about the client and server initializing different things. I did see these methods, but I never thought about checking if I can find the creation of the egg objects with the locations there. Only because I tried to write it down and explain my thought process, I realized this. For example, init objects, init local, init client and init server. Init object is huge, and just by looking a bit over it, you can see that it's linear and just creating a lot of objects. No program logic in here. So how can we quickly investigate this? Scrolling and reading by hand is a bit tough, so I decided to write a few lines of Python using the Binary Ninja API. I have to say, I find the API documentation and design a little bit frustrating at times. I feel like it could be easier, but compared to IDA or Hopper, it's not that bad. You can get it to work, you just have to read the documentation carefully. And so this for loop here goes over all lifted instructions and looks for a call, gets the call target address, which is a function, so we get the function of the address and then the name of it. If the name contains egg, we print where we found that original call. So here we have all of the egg pickup location calls. Let's have a quick look at one. So here it calls the constructor of this class, then calls the operator new, so it creates a new object of this, and then in fact it does this for all eggs. FYI, if you find it crazy how fast I read this assembler code, I don't. You see, I don't care about the instructions in detail. Just by reading the functions it calls, it already makes sense. I black out everything else. So let's keep going with not reading assembler. At some point, we create a new vector for the item pickups, and here we also create a new 3D vector. This vector is initialized with 3 parameters. See these special registers XMM0, XMM1, and XMM2? These are registers used for floating point operations. You rarely see them in regular programs, but of course, heavily used in things like games. So these 3 hardcoded values here must be floats, not integers. So let's change the type to float. And we get the location of one of the eggs. So this is a second method to solve this challenge. I'm super happy that I looked into that, and I only did it thanks to you motivating me to make videos.